Hi there. Welcome to stampityourself.com. My name is Connie Ray, and today's tutorial is this gorgeous little Easter box. Isn't it cute? It's got little bunnies stamped all over it with some little cotton tails, and it's also got, are you ready? Some Easter eggs. Isn't that cute? Got all these lovely Easter eggs inside. So I'm going to show you how. Oh, my little bow's coming off. I'm going to show you how I have created this. I love this. This is so natural. It's just beautiful. It's on, I've made it out of crumb cake cardstock from Stampin' Up. So crumb cake is the go. And I've used Versamark, but for this tutorial, I'm going to actually use crumb cake tone on tone so that you can see it clearly. So, I think the last tutorial I uploaded, it wasn't as clear as I'd like it to be in terms of images. So I'm doing this one a little bit differently, but this is actually done in Versamark. And you can use Versamark or you can use tone on tone, which is crumb cake. Okay, now I've done the label, but I will talk to you about that in a moment. So first of all, you're going to need 2 pieces of crumb cake, the base. And I suggest you write a little B in the corner in pencil that you can probably rub out later, or very small, or just a little mark to indicate that this is the base, because there isn't a lot of difference in sizes. So the base is 5 11/16 by 5 11/16. That's the base. The lid is 5 3/4 by 5 3/4. You need a little piece of crumb cake for the sentiment label, and that is measuring 1 7/8 in width and 3 7/8 in length, and a piece of white cardstock just to pop behind it, and it helps with the color of the washi tape, although in this instance it hasn't really done much, so you could just use a big piece of washi tape. But I have put white cardstock underneath, and that is 2.5 by 4. Okay, and I will walk you through most of it as we go. All right, so as I suggested, I've already stamped the label. Now, the label that I've used on this box is out of the gorgeous set of Happy Celebrations. And I'm using the word celebrate. Now, this box is really quite deceiving. It's called Happy Celebrations, the actual stamp set itself. And these are huge. Look how big these letters are. Aren't they awesome? So, celebrate is a very big word in this package. It's the width of this box. So, it gives you a good idea. So basically, I have stamped that in Versamark, and I have put some washi tape just on the corners here. The washi tape that I have used is from the collection of A Pop of Pink, and I have used the whitest one, which is this one here. It's got little bits of colour in it and goes nicely just on the bottom of the label to add a little bit of blending into the box. So that's the label that's going to go on top. Let me just have a look, make sure that's right. Yep, that's how it's going to look. All right, so the next thing that we can do is, after you've stamped your label and you've got your label out of the way, bring your cardstock in. And what we're going to do is we're going to put a little piece of scratch paper down, and we're going to get our ink. And we will start with the base. And what you need to do is then get your next stamp set that you're going to be using, and that is going to be the Perpetual Birthday Calendar set. And I'm using this little icon here. It looks kind of fuzzy, and it's not the camera. It's actually, for once, it's not the camera. It's actually quite fuzzy, and it reminds me of little bunny tails because it's nice and soft and fluffy. So we're using that one along with the little bunny out of the basket bunch, and here's the little bunny here, and it's in the basket bunch set. And I have stuck them on my block together like this, and I'll show you exactly what I've done. I am going to go around now and just use my crumb cake, and I'm using the crumb cake because instead of the Versamark, because I want to make sure that you actually see what I'm doing, and you can do it then in either crumb cake or you can do it in Versamark. It's up to you what color. So basically, we're just going to go around and we're just going to be stamping down our little friend all over the place. There we go. Isn't it cute? It's just adorable, this guy. The way that these go together, they're just too cute. Just watch your corner of your block, so make sure that you don't get any smudges anywhere. Rotate it as many times as you like to come up with the effect that you want. Let's see. Oh, I hope you can see. So this is going to be the base. Let's have a look here. That looks pretty good. I might just go around the edges a bit, put one little bunny here. Ooh, I think I'll put him like that. Oh, sorry guys. Try and keep you all in focus. And I'll put one bunny here. A bit of fuzzy cottontails up there. I think we're sort of looking like we're getting somewhere. We're making an impression. And I think I will pop that one like that. Okay, that looks pretty covered. All right, so that's going to be the base. And you do exactly the same thing for the lid. Regardless of whether you're going to see it all or not, it doesn't matter. The process is just as easy to do. And this is a good one to make with kids too, because it's so instantaneous and it's fun. And get those gorgeous little bunnies just sticking up to say hi. Keeping you in focus there. Let's have a look. We'll go. Try and pop as many bunnies as you can on, because that's what makes it so cute. And I think this one can go in the corner here. Just make sure that you're still wiping off your edges of your block, just so you don't get a great big streak right in the middle of everything. But that'll be the last thing you want, and then you'd have to start again. Think I can, you can rest assured that I'm speaking from experience. This is not the first take, as they say. Take 20. Well, not that many, but you know, not that far off either. You can see that it's drying, and as it dries out, it looks a little bit lighter as well, so that's kind of looking really cute. Now, if you've got a white pencil, you could do what I will show you, what I have done with the little bunnikins. And it just looks really cute to make the little fluffy tails with a little bit of whiteness around those little fluffy bits that I have used on the bunnies in there. I think that's kind of okay. Let's have a look. So when you're stamping, you just make sure that your images are pretty much, regardless of what the outcome of the box is, it's going to be all over your box. So you just want to make sure that you've got little bunnies popping up everywhere. I could squeeze another one there, I would, but anyway, I think I'm probably being a bit too pedantic. So I will leave it at that and take out my horrible scratch paper. So you should have two pieces of crumb cake stamped in crumb cake, one being the base because we've marked it in the base, and one being the lid. How cute! Doesn't it look fabulous? All right, so I'm covered in stuff. All right, so the next thing we want to do is to grab our base, and we are going to score our base. Now, the base measurements, as I said before, and I'll just repeat them again in case you need to hear them again. It's 5 and 11 sixteenths by 5 and 11 sixteenths, and we're going to score at 1 inch all the way around. I'm sure I might just turn that over so I can see the score line. Okay, 1 inch on all the sides. It's very easy to do this box. And this box I have actually watched somebody else create it, and that lady's name is Stamping with Amore, and I will include her link. She put a window box in hers and it looked just as glorious, but she did decorate her box a lot differently. So I'm just doing mine a little bit differently, but the base of the box is the same. So I will put a link in there to show you who she is. And now the lid is measuring 5 3/4 by 5 3/4, and we're again going to score at 1 inch on all four sides. Yes, I like Stamping with Amore. She's got lovely items. Obviously, she's overseas. She's not in Australia. So if you wanted to purchase things from Stamping Up, you can't get them via herself. But you can learn a lot from her. She's got some lovely tutorials. She's one of the ladies that I follow. There's quite a few ladies I follow, and they're just fantastic. She's one of them. Okay, so now we're just going to, I might just score, zoom back out a bit so we can see what's going on. Oh, one more in. Okay, so we're going to obviously go up and we're going to cut into, I'm just looking for something as I speak to you and I can't find it, so that's fine. Okay, we're just going to score, cut and score on our little tabs so that the box comes together, and you're just going to score in, nip that bit out, and just make it neat. Might use the bigger ones. Oh gosh, now I'll probably chop something off. I shouldn't. Score up to the line. Sorry, cut up to the score line. Take out the little notch and then just bring it into alignment. It just goes together so much better. And it doesn't look ugly and yucky. So just cut up to the notch. Sorry guys, I got out of camera again. I'm trying to do it closer because the image, I'm worried about you not being able to see how gorgeous this box is. So going up to the score line, notching out the corner. Oh, I think I just took out half of it then. And notching over to the other side so that you've got your lid notched. And we're going to do the same for the, oh, that was the lid. Yes, that's right. And this is the base, but it doesn't really matter. Oh, it does matter, big core. It does matter, but it doesn't matter in this instance because we've got that little B in the corner there and we know which is our base. But it does matter because they are just a little bit different. But only just. It goes together very snug, this little box. It's so adorable. It's a very handy go-to box. You can use it for anything. And you can use it in different colours as well. I reckon it'd look really good with, you know, like tone on tone if you did in the Easter pink and the Easter blue and the Easter yellow. You know, those colours, because they just look really good. And you can get the eggs to match and it's just so pretty. Okay, so I have cut into the box and I am just going to burnish my lines that I have scored. So, doesn't it look cute? Okay, so we're just going to burnish. Last one. There we go. Now I'm going to use Tombow. It depends what you want to put into the little box in terms of what you would use to hold it together. The Tombow is sort of like, for me it's usually pretty reliable. So I'm just going to use Tombow on mine. Oh, I forgot to do my colouring. I'll do it on the base. Or is this the base? See what I mean? You have to write down what. Oh, this is the base. Okay. Okay. That's why you have to write it down, because people will forget. They get carried away with things. So just bringing up your the box, and we're bringing up the lines just to meet perfectly on the edge. Whoop, that didn't go too perfect, did it? There we go. Okay, don't stay. It does work, I can assure you. There we go. And there is the lid. Is it? Yes, it is. See, I can't remember myself. Okay, that's the lid. Isn't it cute? And I have forgotten to color, but I will show you what I did to improve the color. This is an option. You don't have to if you don't have time and if you don't want to. With the a white pencil, I just went into the little fuzzy things that look like little cotton tails. They remind me of bunny tails, that's why I like them. And I've just gone in between each one and put a stroke of white in between. I'll bring this into focus so that you can see. So the little cotton tails there. I'm doing getting my white pencil and I'm just going in there and I'm highlighting just around and I'm following, going definitely in between the lines. I'm not just colouring over the top of it, I'm just going deliberately in between the lines because it just makes it look a little bit more effective. And I forgot to do it on the lid, and as I was sticking it down, I was thinking, well, it doesn't really matter. You don't need to do it. I just did it because I liked the look of it. See how it's bringing the little cotton tails into focus. It's so cute. Think I need to sharpen my pencil just about. Let me see whether I've got another white one here. I'm using the Prismacolor. Colors, I should say, or the Prisma pencils. How's that? That sounds a little bit better, doesn't it? They're very soft. So if you go around all the little cotton tails and just highlight all those little strokes, you'll find that it actually stands out really well, and it just looks really cute. You don't need to do, I wouldn't do the little ones. I'm just doing the big ones. So there, you can't really see it. You can see it like when I've done it, but you can't really see how it makes it look more effective. But you can there. See how it's done there on one side and it's not on the other? Whoop, here we go. There you go. One side's done, one side's not. So yes, that's what I did. Actually, I could. Do the lid. You can do it, obviously, I think. Yep, you can do it if you wanted to. If you forget to do it like I did, you can just add it if you wanted to, but just don't push too hard and give you a glue time to set. There you go. Yeah. What is okay. There you go. You can just see the little differences anyway, and it does make a difference when you've got it in real life. So one day I will return with a camera. All right, and the other thing I did color with too was R11, which is a Copic marker, and I have, oh, just thrown the lid off. I have gone over the little bunny ears, and I've actually done this upside down so that I get the right shape in my bunny ears. And I've just put some pink in the ears with the Copic marker, and it leaves a lovely little color there. Not a very deep dark color, but enough. It dries, and it ends up going just this light color of pink. It's quite cute. So I have found that going backwards around the shape of the ear, if you're not really good at drawing and coloring in, or you're learning like me, because I'm only really just learning to use Copics, and I'm so far. I look at other people and they're just so brilliant, and I think, oh, I've got so much to learn. Okay, and this bunny ear. So, and once it dries, it you can just see a tad of pink, and it looks really cute. Matches the eggs. It looks like it's actually crumb cake when you're doing it, but then it dries and it has a little bit of a pink tinge to it, and it's just enough to sort of like set the active, like set a little point of interest for it. It's so cute. And if you wanted to, you could color in the little bow ties. It's entirely up to you how you do it. Or you can go over it with a darker color. You can spend as much time coloring in these little bunnies as you want, really. And I think I could sit and play for hours, but that's not just not going to happen right now. But yes, let me see if I can find one that's dried for you. It doesn't take long to dry the alcohol marker, and I don't think you're really going to see much of a change here under my little camcorder thing here. But if you look at it, you can actually see that there's a little bits of pink in the ears, so that's kind of cute. Okay, so I'll just put some glue, and we are up to the base. How are we going for time? Shouldn't be too much longer. So we'll get this out of the way. So we'll just finish off the base. Yeah, like I said, you can colour in like the little bow ties. I was playing with them before, and you can do the same colours as the foil and the Easter eggs. And oh, it's so cute. Such a cute little box. Okay, we're just putting on some Tombow, bringing our box together. Okay, fingers crossed, folks. It all comes together. Oop, and there you go. Look at that. Fits like a glove. And it looks so cute, doesn't it? Isn't that a gorgeous little darling box? I love it. It's so cute. Okay, so we've got all that sorted. I don't even know what I've done with my draft now. Oh, yes. Okay. Now, to cut the time short, so I don't hold you up any further, we're going to just quickly look at the inserts. I'll just get the box out. Oop, let me just zoom back out so you can see what I'm doing. There we go. Okay, so you've got inserts that you can put in here. Okay, oh, let me just take that out. All right, oh, all right. So the inserts are going to be whatever color you want, but basically this is how they're done. So the first insert is 5.5 by 3 5/8, and then you score it at 1 1/3. Oh, sorry, 1 3/4. 2 3/4 and 3 3/4, and you fold it in a mountain fold like that, and you push it in your, is that the right one? Is that the base or the bottom? Right, yes, no, it's the base. Pop it in like that. Then you've got the second piece, which is going to be exactly the same procedure, and that's 5.5 by 1 5/8, and again that is scored at 1 3/4, 2 3/4, and 3 3/4. And that is folded in a valley fold like that, and that's just going to go over to, oh God, I'm silly. It's going to provide you with another little spot to pop your eggs, so that's going to act as a little divider in your box. Is that how I had those colors in? I can't remember how I had them in now. Doesn't matter, it all works. Okay. And a bit of fits perfectly. So you can get quite a lot in there, can't you? It's quite good. All right. So the next thing I have done is that let me bring in my little made one. We will look at sticking on. Okay, I've just got to trim off the edges of my. Oh, did I? Oh, I think I must. Hang on, I'm a bit confused. Did I make another label for this? Or no, I didn't. Sorry, my computer's going strange. Okay, I thought I did a different label. Anyway, no, I did. I've thrown it somewhere. Oh, there it is. Because I've already prepared it. Okay, because I wanted to save time. There you go. I did do it. All right, so that's the label. And we're just going to pop some dimensionals on that, I think, and we are going to stick it down. A good amount of dimensionals on it, I think. A nice strip at the back to pop it right up. There's an Easter egg in there that's keeping my lid from going down properly. Okay, so we'll just pop this on. Any way you like, it doesn't matter. I think we should have it at least facing with the bunnies facing us. There you go. I have also quickly tied a figure eight. Oop, I don't know if I can do it now because I'm trying to rush. But 1/8, 1/8. This is how I do my twine. And I do it in a figure eight. And then I snip it. I try not to cut my finger off because I am one of those people who always burns myself. Oh, gets my fingers stuck in twine, you know, all that stuff. There we go. So I then used some glue dots, if I can find them, to stick my bow down. Oh, those glue dots are so strong, aren't they? Okay, just popping that on there like so. And I think I'm going to just make that a little bit more, just get a little glue dot and roll it into like a little sausage and just pop that underneath so that it actually, oh, it stays down. There we go. All right. And I have used some glue. Oh. And I have managed to use these. What are these ones? These are the fancy frost sequins. And these are the sequins that actually these sequins actually go with the Easter egg colors. So that's kind of cool. I'm just trying to get some glue out of the little thing right now because it does look really nice. Oh, there we go. Action. Something's happening. I can just find the. No, that's not going to work. That'll do. So obviously you can just pop on a couple of sequins. Oh, that's a clear one. Wish I could just put my fingers on the things that I need without having to. Oh, yes. One here. And I think we'll put one up here somewhere. A pink one just to match out. Oh, is that? No, that's right. I was going to say, is that the same color as the other one? So here I'm just going to pop down the pink one, and that should be enough. And the only other thing I did manage to do was I managed to get my little punch here, and now I've lost my, oh, there we go, punched out a couple of little flowers out of the free glitter paper that is currently with the sale, going on with the celebration stuff at the moment. And I managed to just pop out a few of the little flowers and then just glue them on to give it some more dimension and pretty it up a bit. And I was actually in the process before I started to record of marrying up the sequence with the colours, because they do actually marry up really well. I'll just quickly pull two on. So the pink, I've found that the pink sequence marry up with the pink, and the blue marry up with the blue, and it does make a nice little embellishment. Well, it's kind of like a blue-green, really. So there you go. All said and done. Ta-da! Isn't that pretty? So thank you very much for your patience, and thank you for joining me today. I do hope that you've enjoyed the tutorial. Whoop, sorry. I'm running out of battery and I'm running out of focus. Oh my gosh, it's all happening today. But that is a really fun tutorial to do, and I do hope you give it a try, because it is just delightful and it's such a great little present to give somebody at Easter. So yes, do give it a try. Thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you soon with another tutorial. Bye for now.